I'm Betty, and I'm here with Rick to welcome you to our Easter table. So we're going to start at the head of the table, and I'll show you what we have here, and we'll move around the table and show you what I've chosen for my Easter menu. In this place setting, we have our silverware and our napkin and the plate, and this person has a hot cup of coffee that's just been poured freshly, and also iced tea and some ice water, if desired. I've already placed two of the pieces of bread that I made. What I made this year is cream cheese mini biscuits. So those are really wonderful. They're crusty on the outside and soft and delightful on the inside. Here is a butter pat to go with those. And then the butter for the table is right here. And you'll see the sugar for the table and the cream for the table is there. Coming back up here to the end, this is a very small bowl of the bread, but my family doesn't require a whole lot. So I try to give a few different recipes, but they may not be bountiful because we can't use that much ourselves. Going back to before the meal, you might want to serve your appetizer while people are waiting around for the meal. This appetizer is bourbon hot dogs, and you can see how it's served. You can just put a cocktail pick in the ones that are on a person's plate, and they're easy to eat that way, and they taste delicious. They have brown sugar as well as bourbon flavoring this up, and some tomato ketchup too. Now here is a green salad. I felt like we needed something green on the table because everything I planned this year kind of stayed away from that color. I'm not giving a recipe for this, but in Betty's Kitchen you will find just a basic garden salad. If you want to look that up, I did that many years ago, but it just has the basic things in it. And this is homemade Thousand Island dressing, which is in Betty's Kitchen if you want to look at that recipe. I will give you links in the description box for everything that is on the table. So if you see something you like, you could go to that recipe. Next, we have our roasted red potatoes with smoked paprika. And those just came from the oven minutes ago, and they're just really hot and they're delicious. Also coming straight from the oven are our Kentucky baked beans. These have lots of ingredients, and they're made from canned beans. You may use fresh beans, just use a lima, use a navy bean or something like that as a dry bean and follow the instructions, and then put all the additional ingredients in to get this nice flavor, and you may want to cook them at a low heat for a long time to get this effect. Here we have our entree, and this is roast pork tenderloin. And I didn't try to do anything fancy with it. I just roasted it in the oven. I did put it in aluminum foil inside a roasting pan. And I used coarse ground pepper. And also I salted it well so that it would be nice and flavorful. And it is. I made gravy to go with it. This is a creamy gravy because I used flour and milk as the components in addition to the juices. Now here I have tea on the table, which I always have one or two pitchers, some in the kitchen waiting, but that's our tea. Here is something that is actually not part of the Easter menu. You will not find it listed as an Easter video in Betty's Kitchen, but I made it not too long back, and I thought some people would appreciate being reminded about it because it has no flour in it. And for people with celiac disease or people that are looking for something gluten-free, this is the one thing on the table that I can, well, not the only thing, but the one dessert on the table that I can be sure is gluten-free. It only has four ingredients. These are called miracle cookies. And next along the way, we have some bar cookies. These are caramel bar cookies. And you can make your bars as squares if you want to, or you can make them rectangular If you have a big appetite, then you might want to bite into something like that. It's got some lovely caramel melted inside there. Those are delicious. Now for cake, instead of doing a layer cake or maybe something like an angel food cake or something that was really dramatic, I decided to do something that might be really useful. This is cinnamon swirl cake, and it tastes just like cinnamon rolls. So if you want to use it for breakfast or brunch, it works fine, but it looks pretty on a table like this. So I think that is really something you're going to enjoy. Even if you don't make it for Easter, try it sometime, and I think you'll find it easy to make, much easier than cinnamon rolls. Now the last dish on the table, the last dessert, is right here, which I will have to put together individually for each person. These are brandied peaches and vanilla ice cream. I've already put a large scoop of vanilla ice cream in for my dish, and I will take one peach half for each serving and place that in the dish. And then I have a brandy sauce. It has brown sugar and the juices that came from the peaches, which in my case were pear juice and peach juice. And when all of that goes together in the appropriate way, it makes a wonderful sauce to tie these two together. So I would put about this much on, and that will make a flavorful dessert that a lot of people will enjoy. If you don't want the alcohol, leave the brandy out and you will still have a nice dessert. So that brings us back to the beginning of the table, and it brings me to the point where I want to say thank you for all you have done for me over the years in Betty's Kitchen, and I hope each and every one of you have a wonderful Easter.